Maybe you see me at football. Think I'm a leader.
You may see me as the DECA leader.
Maybe you see me at the games as that only male cheerleader.
You may see me as the nerd with the hard schedule, or just as a soccer player.
Maybe you haven't seen me, and maybe you haven't even taken the chance to look at me.
Maybe you see me in class. Think I'm shy.
Or the loud one who likes to be surrounded by people.
Or maybe you know me as that gay kid.
But do you really know me?
Do you really know me?
There's so much more to me than that.
There's so much more to me than what you guys see.
I have a story too.
All of these lines across my face tell you the story of who I am.
All right, I'm gonna go brush my teeth. Maddie Hayes, that kind of just fell in place there. We've been dating 7 months now. So math I really like because I get the chance to have my football coach as my teacher, so that's really cool. Trying to avoid people, but I don't necessarily like engage in conversation with everyone. I usually don't talk much, so I don't really avoid people. I just don't necessarily make contact with people. People at school would kind of probably categorize me as like antisocial or quiet. And in doing what I do, like playing football and in the position I play at linebacker, is kind of the opposite of what that stereotype is, just because those are usually like really loud and cocky, and I'm just usually not like that during school. So.
Oh, I have a question about this. Yeah.
Caleb, was that on top of the phone? Oh, do you have that?
Yeah. I know. Well, like, honestly, like, was anybody else this?
Yeah. Not as many people as I hoped.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I don't know, like, people are just starting, like, watching
them.
Really?
Because they're new. Because they've just started there.
What is Caleb like in class? Caleb is actually very quiet and does all his work and does a really good job. He is a very good student. He's an excellent student. He's turned everything in, got an A on his test. He works very hard. My first impression is that he looks almost too adult to be in high school. He's a very mature kid. He looks very mature, and as a junior, he's pretty far advanced.
Coming home and playing guitar. That's what really just relaxes me, and even if I'm just listening to music, like, I feel like that's just such an important part to anyone's life, is to kind of interpret music and get to know who they are themselves through that. I started playing guitar in 7th grade here, and kind of just taught myself from then on. So I was diagnosed with bipolar when I was 5, and because of my bipolar is what kind of pushed me in high school to hide under a hole a little bit, just because in junior high, I didn't really deal with situations very well. I came across as this guy who was really just mean and like didn't handle situations that were like a conflict with someone very well. So kind of to get away from that, I guess I'd kind of hide behind that during high school. And my dad has bipolar disorder as well, as well as my uncle. So it's nice to have my dad to talk to because he understands it all. Number one thing to me is my family, and they've supported me through everything, and with all the times that we've moved and my bipolar and all that stuff, they've always been there for me. So that's the number one thing in my life, is my family.
That normally takes me on Mondays.
Ouch.
Get in.
But we normally have the radio blaring.
I kind of like coming to school because it gives you a chance to actually become like more independent and actually find like what your interests are and stuff before you go off to college.
So tell me, how awkward does it feel to know that you're being watched at all times? And every time you pick your nose, they'll be caught on camera.
Well, knowing that I don't pick my nose, it's not that awkward.
Oh, don't lie to yourself, Shauna. We know how much you pick your nose.
Like, everyone normally has this idea of, like, the stereotypes and everything. But here, like, you kind of have it, but it's more blurred. Because, like, for me, I'm friends with, like, three different groups of people. I mostly like pottery and MT because they're just different classes and you don't have to sit all class period taking notes and stuff, and you actually get to do things. Don't hold back. Packing my bags and giving the academy. Today we spent our entire class period near the pond in the southeast corner of the school testing water. A couple of my friends have actually called me a wallflower because I don't really like to be in the middle of everything. I mostly kind of like to watch stuff happen. Probably just because I'm quiet, people normally think that like I'm shy and they don't really know much about me because I'm so quiet, so they don't know if they can actually like connect with me. It's cold inside. They see us as like people that are like really rich and spoiled because we live on this side of town. I don't feel like they're valid, especially with how my life is, because my parents are divorced and my dad has been unemployed for years and he's actually had to go back to school to get a better job. And then my mom is like struggling with finances and stuff because she doesn't have like the best paying job. Only one that's vulnerable.
Impossible. Impossible. I was born to tell you I love you. Isn't that a song already?
I don't really see stereotypes like that people could like easily tell. A lot of people you don't really know unless if you actually get to know them.
Robin Lynn Toomey, born in Fort Collins, Colorado. I usually wake up every morning at 6. Before school, I shower, have breakfast with my dad, and work. High school for me has been really fun. I think that it's a time that everyone figures out who they are and they meet some of the most amazing people in their life. There's not really a specific place at school that I feel uncomfortable. I feel most comfortable surrounded by my friends because they know me the best and I'm comfortable around them. People see me as preppy, fun to be around, and a good sense of humor. So some things people don't know about me would be the background of my blind eye. I was born with a cataract on my lens, which caused my lens not to form all the way before I was born. And after I was born, they did surgery to remove the cataract, and they couldn't save any of the lens. So that happens, that caused the blindness. So a lot of my childhood, we worked on trying to strengthen my left eye, which is my blind eye. And doing that, I had to wear a patch on my right eye. And because that never helped, the doctors finally just decided that it wasn't gonna change and that I just needed to live life with my one eye. During elementary school is when everyone started to realize that my eyes weren't the same and that they were different. And it's really helped me grow as a person, just knowing that, yes, I have a flaw, but there's nothing I can do about it, and it's what makes me different from other people.
High school is awesome. It's been the best 2.5 years that I've ever experienced, and just the culmination of everything that goes into high school life is incredible, and it just makes it one heck of an experience. Like, I'd especially say since I'm involved, that definitely helps because I get to meet all these incredible people and do all these amazing things. Having something to do every day and loving what you're doing is just awesome. It's like there's no other feeling that can compare. I'm excited to go to school and see all my friends and go to my classes, even though they might be stressful sometimes. Like, it's a ton of fun. And then going afterwards to just play outside and just hang out with people, it's great. A lot of my friends are on the soccer team, which is really nice. Just being with my friends and being, because I feel like they just know me best, and like I'm really comfortable around them, and we just talk about everything, and like we laugh about the stupidest things, but it's just awesome. But yeah, usually like we'll go out to lunch or something, or like tonight we'll hang out before the game and after the game. It's worry-free, and I just like feel just really comfortable around them. It's really nice. In the Sam's Club, I didn't get dirt and went to church to get my hands scrubbed. So I've been baptized these 3 or 4 times. After my grandpa died a couple years ago, my grandma moved from India and lived with us for 2 years. And I don't think many people knew that. She learned English really well, which was cool. Like, I just became really, really close to her. Like, she is one of my best friends for sure. She passed away in November, last November. The first month, I'd think about her a lot, like, and just how much, like, oh, she would have done this, and or she would have been doing this, and stuff like that. It was someone who had been there every day for the last 2 years, just not there anymore. But then after that, like, it would just come, like, randomly. I'd suddenly just miss her a lot, and it was weird. But then But now, like, more, whenever we talk about her, it's like more just like really funny things or really funny moments that we had with her. And so it's more, a lot more like up, like happy, yeah, and acceptance now. The best thing that's happened to me in high school is meeting new people, meeting new teachers. Like, the teachers that I've met have really impacted and influenced who I've become.
So you need to tell them that.
Okay. Because I talked to Morgan, and she said some people didn't pay. Certain teachers can make what you may think the most dull and drab subject be extremely fun and awesome. Going along with that, not just the teachers, but also the students that go to Fossil, and hearing all these different stories of people's past and histories, it's really cool, because then you just learn to think about people in a different light. You want to respect what they've been through and respect their past and who they've become, and you just become and grow more accepting of other people. I think what's most important to me is just being satisfied or proud of what I've done and what I've become and what I've been doing. It may not be what other people want, it might not be what other people expect, but as long as I'm happy with what I'm doing and who I am, then I'm fine. And that's what I'm trying to do every day.
Hi. If you hit the middle switch, the light will turn on.
So just do what you normally do.
Okay. I need to do my hair. That is the first step. This is nasty.
Oh, nice.
And teeth whitener.
During my off period, I usually like walk around the school, go say hi to all my favorite teachers that I've had or are gonna have at some point. I'm loud because I'm always loud. Like, in the hallways, I'm loud. At cheer, I'm loud. I'm just a very loud person. I'm spazzy because I'm usually all over the place, like jumping from one person to the next, like just giving hugs and you're wonderful type of thing. And I'm caring because I like to care for people and let them know that they're being taken care of. My classes are okay. Some of them are more stressful than others, but I think that's just part of the high school experience.
So really, that's all you need to know for the test, believe it or not.
When it comes down to it, I'm more willing to put on a happy face and try to cheer up a friend if they really need it.
Abby, you got a salsa with me. Come on, do you know Monica?
Yeah.
Okay, she salsas with me.
I'll watch you.
Okay. All come salsa.
I love everyone, but I truly respect few people.
Did they just paint this lab?
My favorite class is either history with Schley or advanced aerobics with Miss Neal.
What else do they do besides just boycott? Stop buying your stuff. Remember the thing you read, The King's Friends? How do they treat British shopkeepers, Andrew?
They treat British loyalists by like tarring and feathering them, or they'll beat them or keep them prisoner for like a month.
Yeah, through 342 chests of tea, into Boston Harbor.
Didn't they also like burn three of the ships? Do you see these like put your toes on here and then just calves? You just feel that in your calves.
Do you think being gay defines you?
I don't think it does in the least. I just think it's something that most people know about me, so they think it must have something to do with who I am. I got a text from Jackson and my friend Ariel, and they were like, you have to sit with us at lunch tomorrow. And I was like, okay, no problem, but can you tell me why it seems so urgent? And they're like, oh, well, like, we got this text and someone's saying that they're gonna like cut you at school and fight you at school and burn your house down because they know where you live. And that was terrifying. My friends and I went straight to, I think it was like Mr. Wolf, and we like showed him the text and everything like that, and it was taken care of, but it was scary.
A lot of people perceive the gay community in a negative way. In this school especially, I hear a lot about it, but there's several different ways to be negative about it. You could be physically negative about it, like hurt people because of it, or you can be verbally negative about it. It's nobody's business what you do in your personal life. If you want to walk around holding hands with your husband or your girlfriend or whatever, doesn't matter what sexuality you are, you can do it.
Is
it a mic right there?
Yes, this is a mic.
Can I talk into it?
If you really feel the need, but it's going to look pretty strange.
Hi.
After school, I either go to cheer or my friend Kate's house and just chill out there. It's like such a safe haven of sorts, and I'm really close with her parents and her family and everything like that. It's a great place to be, and it's just a very welcoming place, and it's just real fun. I would say people don't know or think about the fact that like everyone can have a bad day. Like sometimes I have bad days too, even though I don't show it.
I'm me, and that's all I can be. I'm me, here's my vulnerability. I'm free, and you can't stop me. I'm free, and that's all I can be.
Hear my story.
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 Escuchen mi historia.
Hear my story.
Hear my story.
Hear my story.
Hear my story.
Yummy, here's my vulnerability. I'm free, and you can't stop me. I'm free, and that's all I can be. Days pass, I'm trying to find who I really am. I've been looking, people don't like the way I dress, so where I'm at,
I've been looking.
I dye my hair, and it's not just vanity.
I've been looking.
Your validation is just not that important to me. And that's all I can be. Can't stop me.